Cerebral palsy is a neurological condition that affects two people differently. In my case, I have mild walking difficulties. I also have a speech and hearing impairment, so therefore I wear two hearing aids on a daily basis. I also have manual dexterity problems, which means I find it hard to use my hand to do simple tasks. The variation of children who grow up to have this condition is hugely. There might be somebody who's in a wheelchair, who's unable to do it for themselves, and then you've got somebody like myself who's typically more than able just to do anything like an able-bodied person can do. In recent years, I've also had to deal with the preconception of other people's attitude towards me, you know. Just because I've got a hearing and speech impairment, people have always had to make the assumption that because Julie's deaf, because Julie doesn't speak well at times, they often think that she just isn't capable. But if you actually get to know me, you begin to realise that I'm just like everybody else, but I just do things in a different way. I just have my own way of coping and my own way of mechanism to dealing with life. I've just been very fortunate to lead a very active life. Nothing has ever stopped me. I've climbed Ben Lomond, I've done a trek across the Andes, I've done the Himalayas. Last October, I did a canoeing expedition down Lost Hill. My motto for life is drive, motivation and passion. And I guess having that sort of focus, having that sort of vision has allowed me to achieve things that I never thought were going to be possible regardless of my disability. But even now, I don't give my disability a second thought because I've overcome so many barriers.
I find it hard to comprehend that it's actually here.
I was just driving in town and I was actually starving it. Yeah, I'm pretty nervous. I'm nervous now. I'll try to fly. Just don't say goodbye. I just want to try now. I just been. I'm so glad that disability rights UK nominated me for this occasion. After a few days of reflection, I think this will mark the start of my life all over again. For what I'm going to do next in the future, it just gives me that kind of a new vision, a new drive to take on the Paralympics 2014 for Glasgow. It's going to be amazing.